I'm Sherman. I'm actually new to this gig, so just a quick question. How many people here actually have done late or hybrid mobile application development before in JS? So those that have raised your hands, I'm sure you are familiar with Apache Cordova. Okay, so what was one of the biggest challenge of working with Apache Cordova, say a year ago? What's the biggest challenge?
Native look and feel.
Yeah, that's one.
Can break.
True. Personally, because I've also been a mobile app developer, one of the greatest challenges that I felt that impeded my work was some of the third-party plugins. Well, obviously, it's open source, but then that comes a problem where, as programmers, sometimes it's very difficult for us to find a right third-party plugin that actually works. And many times we actually find third-party plugins, but we end up having to try and figure out and debug the lines of codes. And then make it even worse, there are some of us that initially when I first started, I was not a native Android developer. Neither was I a native iOS developer. So when I realized that if I had to build my own custom third-party plugin, I have to go to iOS and I have to build the interfacing, I have to go to Android, I have to build the interfacing, and I realized, oh shit, now I have to learn two extra languages. So I'm a lazy programmer. So I admit that. So I realized that when there is actually a way to, I was thinking there must be a better way for us to do native mobile application without the need to learn so many languages. So just a little bit of background, allow me to gloat myself for the next 30 seconds. I'm actually a full stack developer. I did web, desktop, mobile. I've learned the following languages and actually a lot more. I'm currently also a Telerik evangelist and MVP. So if you actually want to follow me, you want to go to my blog, theprogrammingnerd.com, please feel free to visit. You also can Skype me. So if you have any questions related to native script, to JavaScript, to any programming language. So I kind of like one-liners, but this isn't really a one-liner. What is native script? So I feel that native script is actually the truly native mobile app that you can create with only one code base, which is JavaScript. So why? I'm sure we are all here because we are all, or most of us, would be JS trained developers. And secondly, it's actually open source, so it's really free. Oh, it's not really free, it's free. Okay, and we also have compatibility with AngularJS. For those of you who actually did AngularJS, you know that AngularJS 2 just recently came out, like a month, 2 ago, or last year. So with AngularJS 2, now there is actually a very big community support for native script as well. So how do you use native script? How do you build? How do you start? So actually a very easy way is to start using the native script command line interface and subline text. I see a lot of people that use Mac, so I'm sure you have subline text somewhere. If you haven't, go download it. Oh yes, I missed something. Sorry, I was nervous. So for those users who are actually interested to try out some of the more complex app development, deployment tools out there, we actually have a Telerik platform. So that is actually one option that you can go and look at. I won't go into that today. And for those who are actually .NET developers who are familiar with Visual Studio, you can actually get Visual Studio as well. And you actually run it through Visual Studio. Okay, I know this is really small. Yeah, but just to share, if you want to build native script, there are actually two ways to do it. One is TypeScript and one is JavaScript. I think one of the plus points of having TypeScript is that there are a lot of developers who might come from a different programming language background, and they might not have really been a front-end developer before. So having TypeScript provides that familiarity because it actually looks like your object-oriented code in Java or C#. Okay, so I actually have some samples. You can actually go to github.com/nativescript, and you actually can download the NativeScript code, and it's actually open source. We also have all the sample apps, the showcases. I got to admit that I was preparing a demo today, but I'm sure we all know what Murphy's Law is. So I'm sorry, I can't do that today. So looking forward, what to expect for NativeScript? We are actually releasing the next version. NativeScript is very new. I remember when I was working on a mobile app for United Nations last year in May for their conference, I was actually using Apache Cordova. So at that point in time, NativeScript was only 0.5a alpha. And it's already 1.6 and it's stable. And we are actually looking at one new release every 2 months. So that's how fast we're actually progressing. Some of the things that will be included in 1.6, which is coming out next month, is integration with Visual Studio Debugger. We have the autocomplete box component, Firebase integration. I'm not a Firebase expert, I don't know what's that. We have AdMob integration, design templates, material design support for Android. So yeah, I'm done. So are there any questions? Any questions about NativeScript?
Yeah. How
does this compare with React? Okay, React is, in my opinion, React is more of the UI. For NativeScript, we actually provide the native API where it's actually the full stack. It's like having Apache Cordova, but now I don't need to go and look for third-party plugins anymore. It's everything in one package, and I can just build a mobile app right out of that.
Is it a web view?
It's not a web view.
That's the thing. People would ask the question. Actually, I already prepared that. On the way here today, I was looking at the FAQ. So to answer your question, like for example, Apache Cordova, they actually run on a web view. So everything such as your layout is actually built based on the web paradigms layout. But for NativeScript, it's actually built on top of the native layout design, the framework. So it's actually different. So everything that is being compiled for NativeScript compiles directly to binary. Yeah.
Any questions?
Okay, sure. So is this something like a Qt?
Qt?
You know Qt?
Qt?
Yeah, invented by...
I'm not very familiar with Qt. Ah, okay.
Yeah, so they also did the same thing. They can combine, we should compile to binary. So is this similar? Or?
I have to get back to you on that. Yeah, but based on what you described, I would say it sounds similar. Yeah. Yeah, so there was another question.
For those who don't use Sublime or Visual Studio, any other way to?
Right now is Sublime Visual Studio. We have the what I shared earlier. It's an option, Telerik platform. It provides a desktop editor as well as an in-browser editor. Yeah.
Command line.
It's command line.
So for command line,
Visual Studio
is free
now, right?
Sorry?
Visual Studio.
Yes, precisely. Thanks for mentioning that.
Just to take note, we have the Visual Studio code, which is part of the VNix project that Visual Studio started. So Visual Studio Code, you can install it on your Mac environment, your Linux. So then, yes, you can run off that as well. Yep.
Does it abstract away certain views, like, for example, like React Native, it abstracts away the progress bar on iOS and Android. So even though, I mean, in iOS and Android, both have different class names. So does NativeScript actually abstract into like a single class? Like
yes, correct. Yes. Yep.
You should iOS and Android support. Any support for Windows Mobile in the future?
Yes. Very good question. I also prepared that. The roadmap for 2016, yes. Anyone?
Okay. Yes.
So I minimized my pain with Cordova using the ARM framework. And I found it, let's say, for lazy developers quite nice because that will take care of a lot of your IONIX. Are there any plans like that? Because IONIX sits basically on top of Cordova, but not necessarily fixed marriages. Are there any plans to say, okay, you build an adapter so I can continue using my Ionic stuff and then just use native script a lot.
Yeah. In fact, for native script project, it's an ongoing development, ongoing project, and we actually do understand that there are a lot of developers out there that actually want to work with other frameworks. So there are pipeline plans to actually build that as well. So you don't have to throw away Ionic. And you can get rid of Apache Cordova.
I like Apache.
Oh, sorry.
Not necessarily the Cordova project.
thanks for the question.
All right, thank you.
Thanks.